furniture together, and the big desk had not arrived yet. It was just it's meant so much Scancor over the years. It's great. Obviously, I will say some things that are very similar to those that have spoken here before, but I also think it is important to think about our own discipline, social science, our own research area, and organization research maybe in particular, and see how does this sort of institution framework of impact, of creating impact and building structures for impact, how can it affect and have impact on our own type of research? How should we deal with this new kind of idea on knowledge transfer or societal impact? And I should say that this is sort of, as many of you know, I'm in transition from being an academic bureaucrat since more than a decade into back into research, more full-time researchers. So this is sort of a mix of my experience as a bureaucrat and some preliminary research result and some ideas about future research. So, of course, there is much emphasis on knowledge transfer and impact, in not least in European research policy. And Renate mentioned some of those. I think one interesting thing is this co-production of knowledge and open science, where it's the whole idea is also to sort of plan research to be transferable, to have an impact before, and how should we deal with that? And it's not only in universities, but of course a lot in research funding of, organizations that this is a highly topical issue. I would like to just make three small remarks on this development. First, on what is knowledge in this sense, in this impact discourse? What transfer counts as knowledge transfer? And if we are to think about the transfer from university to business or from university to society, we have studied ourselves much of the other way around, and we heard about it yesterday also when we talked about universities, knowledge transfer from business to university, and how do these two trends sort of interact? And then this expansion of management knowledge and the discourse on impact and the measures taken to promote knowledge impact, societal impact. What's our role in this, and how should we really relate to this whole trend? So what kind of transfer of organization research count in this? Well, as all several of the previous speakers have said, it's really tangible, instrumental research, and that is not only true for technical and medical research, but as true for social science. It's interesting to see in the European Union and in the framework program, Horizon 2020, there has been a lot of talk about how much funding goes to social sciences and humanities research. And it turns out that they end up calculating that quite a lot of money goes into social science research. But if you look into those figures, the kind of research supported is really very instrumental, largely what we would call consultancy, consultants' work. So management consulting is defined in these ways as social science research. Now, of course, for us, I think it's fair to say that much of the research that is done in and around Scancor does not fit into these categories, but it's more of a critical reflection, conceptual, empirical work, more explaining what is going on and maybe reacting to those models that circulate. So how should we relate to this then? And what is the power of the frameworks, of funding schemes, of measurements, of the sort of the framework in universities where you also have merits that really are based on how much the transfer you do. How should we deal with this? One way, of course, is to sort of to try and show how you have impact. And a fond memory I have is when Mike Power became an honorary doctor at Uppsala University. He gave a very nice talk on how to be an impactee. During the dinner, the Minister of Higher Education was there, and he wanted to discuss about audit society with Mike. And Mike was very happy because then he could add sort of some points to his impact statement that he is turning. And that is, of course, one way of looking at impact, that also the spreading of our concepts, our data, is a kind of an impact. But how much is this really? Does this whole framework drive our research to be much more instrumental, much more applied, much more planned in beforehand in terms of societal impact? I think we see that a lot among our, especially the younger colleagues. So, of course, we have this expansion of management knowledge that is from the other side, and we have had many of us have put a lot of effort into research that is more reacting towards this. While if I look at the European Union data, it's this kind of research, what is called research, this kind of knowledge transfer that is called research. So we are faced in a situation, I think, where the kind of knowledge transfer that in social science that actually counts most is the kind of knowledge that we are criticizing or reacting or reflecting upon. I think that this impact, this very instrumental impact notion is also driven by the changes of university governance that Peter Malsen was talking about yesterday. And here is just a very small study that Peter Edlund and I do. It's part of a more broader studies of public-private relations. But what we see is this is the employment background of external board members in Swedish higher education organizations from 2004 to 2017. There are approximately 30 to 35 higher education institutions, and all of these are public, and the government appoints the external board members from that after they have been nominated by various bodies. And what we see here is over the years, the politicians go down as a group in these boards, whereas the business stands on the top all the time, and also culture and society goes down. There are fewer representing this kind of part of society. Interesting enough, the research and education goes up, and that is behind those figures is that the smaller university colleges have members in their boards from the bigger universities so that they can learn how to be real universities. But it's really the sort of the public, they are publicly employed, those that dominating the boards. And I think that these, of course, with this very clear governance of the universities that we have heard of today and yesterday, this impact discourse is clearly even more sort of driving the impact discourse into this very instrumental way. So, is this the kind of impact we want? And of course, we should. I've discussed these things at length with Jim over the years, and so I just picked one of many quotes from him, and where he says that if a manager asks an academic consultant what to do, and that consultant answers, then the consultant should be fired. Well, the management consultants are not fired, of course, but should we be? Should we give advice, or should we just not? Or should we at all bother about being relevant? So I think that if we try to be relevant in terms of doing our sort of reflective, empirical, conceptual work, how much societal impact do we have? And I think that the prime example now is, as a bureaucrat, I've been struggling with all this planning that we have to do. You know, in a research funding body, we spend half of the year of planning for the next year to come, right? And there are all strategies and plans, and of course I know this from research, but when having to do it myself, it's just, I'm shocked how much that is, how much emphasis it is on the planning of in organizations. And organization studies have spent decades and decades on criticizing this kind of planning. It's very much based in Jim March's work with technology of foolishness we have talked about. We have talked about decoupling. And when we give courses both to students and to executives, we try to reflect upon these limitations of planning and maybe the adverse effects of it. But it doesn't seem to help at all. So we try to be relevant, but there is not. It doesn't seem to be possible. And that kind of relevance, I don't think, is measured in these impact measures that we now have. So I've tried to say a few words on what kind of knowledge is being transferred and where, from, and to. And I think it is very much not the sort of the main for our, I guess, most of us here, the mainstream social science idea of empirical explaining, describing and explaining the society, but the kind of knowledge that counts in these impact measures and funding schemes for impact is a much more instrumental knowledge. And then we can ask, of course, what impact does that kind of framework have on our research? Do we run for the money? Do researchers run for the money and for the merits? They may turn the whole social science field into becoming even more sort of less critical, less reflective, less empirical, conceptual, and more into sort of very instrumental kind of advice. So what happens to the critical, the more reflective, and the basic research in light on the emphasis of knowledge transfer and societal impact? What role do we have and what is our role? I think these four questions I have thought a lot about in the position as I now have in the research funding organization, but I also think they are extremely important topics for research. And these are topics for research where we have lots to base on Jim March's work and his way of seeing how research is being changed with a changed organizational and institutional framing of that research. So I think we need to think about what is social science research and what's the role of social science and organizational research more precisely in this sort of impact society that we live in. So thank you.